Hey, it's ShadowACS again. I was originally going to review a different anime today, but it turned out the show I started watching was so horrible that I had to take a break from it for a few weeks. So that'll be an experience you all get to look forward to next time. But in the meantime, I'm going to take on a request that a lot of people have asked me for, and that's to review the second and third seasons of RWBY. I guess it figures that a lot of people have been asking me to do this review because I did review the first season when it came out, and really enjoyed it. While RWBY has never been any sort of perfect masterpiece, I do think it is a very inspirational and important show, and that it proves that anyone can make their own anime without having to go through a complex studio system. As for these two seasons themselves, I have somewhat differing thoughts on both of them, but the short version is, they're both good. They still have the same great characters, the same witty comedy, and the same great action. And chances are, if you liked season one, you're probably not going to be disappointed. One minor note about these seasons is that the episode length is a lot longer. While the first season had 16 episodes that were about 5 to 10 minutes apiece, these seasons both have 12 episodes that are about 15 minutes. Personally, I like this new formula a lot better because it makes the week you spend waiting for each episode to come out seem so much more worth it. The longer episode length makes it feel less like a bunch of anime shorts someone put online and more like a full-length show. Anyway, let's start by looking at season 2. The story begins appropriately right where the first season left off, with the girls continuing their education at Beacon Academy and learning how to hunt monsters. Only this time, the story is a lot less focused on their school life and them getting to know each other, and more on them actually going out and fighting bad guys. Now that the girls all know each other and have become friends, we're constantly seeing them interact as a team. These elements, in my opinion, are what make this season much better than the first. I'm gonna be honest, while I think Beacon Academy is a pretty cool environment, it's never been one of my favorite things about the show. I think ever since the Harry Potter books came out, there's been a lot of supernatural schools and fantasy stories, and let's be honest, Hogwarts is just so good an environment that no other fantasy school is going to compete with it. To me, the hallmarks of RWBY have always been the action, the characters, and the comedy, and they're all done fantastically here. The action, what can I say? It's still just as spectacular as the first season. The animation is outstanding, you can follow the flow of it perfectly, there's tons of creatively designed weapons and moves. Even as someone who's not hugely into over-the-top anime action, these are just a blast to watch. And for all the over-the-top action scenes in the show, they do set aside an appropriate amount of time for character drama. John and Pyrrha, for example, start growing much closer as a couple in this season, and there's a really genuine tender moment between Blake and Yang, dealing with their pasts and what the two of them are struggling with. RWBY, of course, is still the same plucky, awesome lead she was in the first season. She's wild, energetic, and funny, and has a big heart. He's probably my favorite character in the show. Speaking of the characters, another thing that gets a lot better from the first season is Weiss. She's still the more straight-laced one, but they give her a lot more comedic moments to balance her out better. And all the scenes from the first season with her being a bitch to RWBY are over and done with. The two have now become full-time friends, which I think makes her a lot more entertaining. The comedy in the show is still awesome. And what I especially love about it is how well integrated the comedic writing is into the rest of the show. A great example of this is this one scene in the first episode of this season, when RWBY is explaining to everyone what her plans for the semester are. But while this is going on, we can see Nora tossing grapes into Yang's mouth from across the table. And later, Yang tells a terrible joke and Nora hits her in the face with an apple instead. What's so great about this bit is that it didn't need to be in this scene. But by having it, it turns a moment of otherwise boring exposition into something funny. The whole show is filled with great comedic writing like this, where they know how to insert humor into just the right moments to make it consistently entertaining. And speaking of funny scenes, of course I have to mention what I swear has to be the most awesome food fight in the history of visual fiction.
Justice will be swift! Justice will be painful! It will be delicious!
One thing about the show I've never talked about before is the villains. The main one they keep fighting in these two seasons is a criminal named Roman Torchwick, who's a pretty entertaining bad guy. He's kind of like a cross between Team Rocket and Alex from A Clockwork Orange. I like how he's kind of got this annoyed employee attitude about him, where he's trying to get these jobs done for his bosses, but these damn annoying kids keep getting in the way. I'll admit I kind of wish they made him a bit more over the top or a bit more funny, but I enjoyed watching him enough. We also get introduced to a couple new villains in this season, named Emerald and Mercury, who are henchmen working under an evil mastermind named Cinder, who's presumably behind most of what's going on. They're a really entertaining trio to watch, and they know how to make them fun and intimidating in just the right moments. And actress Jessica Nigiri, who voices Cinder, just loves chewing over every single line. She's clearly having the time of her life voicing this character. I can almost picture her making the same evil expressions as she's saying her lines in the recording booth.
People assume she's fated for victory, when she's really taken fate into her own hands.
So the second season, safe to say, was a pretty huge success. But the third season is where things started to get a little more complicated. On February 1st, 2015, Monty Oom, the creator of RWBY and one of the huge names at Rooster Teeth, passed away. He was just 33 years old. So for RWBY fans, the question was suddenly raised of what would happen to the series. Well, thankfully, the people at Rooster Teeth decided to honor Monty's dream and continue the show, and we did eventually get a third season. But the result wasn't what a lot of people expected. I used to think this season was the worst one and kinda wondered if Monty's death contributed to that. But after watching it again, I actually think it's the best. It definitely does have some flaws though, and they are worth addressing. The first half of the season is about this fighting tournament that they had built up in seasons 1 and 2. And the first thing about this season that's kind of a problem is, that's mostly all that's going on. Don't get me wrong, the action in RWBY is always outstanding and fun to watch, and this is too. But all the other fights before this were connected to the story, there was a dramatic reason for them. Here it just seems like fighting for fighting's sake, and it kinda takes some of the fun out of it when it isn't moving the plot forward in any way. There are some good elements worth noting in the first half, though. For example, we get introduced to some new characters. Weiss's older sister Winter finally makes an appearance, as does RWBY's Uncle Crow, voiced by none other than Vic Mignogna. That's right, Edward Elric himself does the voice of this character, and he just owns it.
Well, thank goodness I'm out there risking my life to keep you all informed.
Crow,
communication's a two-way street, pal. You see this? That's the send button.
Also, extra points for this awesome line.
If you were one of my men, I would have you shot.
If I was one of your men, I'd shoot myself.
As for Winter, she's an okay character, but I don't really like the writing in the first scene where she appears. She's supposed to be a stern but supportive role model for Weiss, but when we first see her, she just comes off like a total bitch.
Nor did I come here to watch my own blood fail so miserably in battle, but it appears I have no choice in the matter.
But we won!
Only a novice would refer to that as a victory. I counted at least 3 strikes missed.
Thankfully, however, she does make up for this in a later scene where she's actually being helpful and supportive to her sister. The second half of the season, however, is where things take an incredibly dark turn. Really out of nowhere, in fact. In the span of just 1 or 2 episodes, the show goes from a lighthearted fantasy comedy to this big epic battle with characters getting killed off and all this other horrible stuff happening. Now, the creators have stated that what they were going for is something similar to what the Harry Potter books did, where the story sort of grows up with the characters. Well, the problem with that argument here is that the Harry Potter books got gradually darker with each installment. They still felt like you were reading the same stories. Here, the tonal shift is so sudden and out of nowhere that it's really jarring. However, with that said, the drama is the best the series has ever had, which is what I think puts this season above the others. There's a part where Pyrrha has to make a really uncomfortable decision about what to do next with her life, and you really feel the crushing weight of what this is putting her through. And we even get introduced to some of the more fascinating lore of this world. There's also a phenomenal bit where they go into the backstories of Mercury and Emerald, and how they set up their evil plan with Cinder. What I love about this bit is that they give very few details about Cinder's past, but they tell us just enough that you get really interested in knowing more. We learn how she set up this whole evil plan, but not why she's doing it. That part is still left to be revealed later. This is the first part where she goes from just being a shadowy mastermind to a genuinely terrifying threat. Whenever she confronts one of the characters, you feel like they're gonna lose to her. Whereas the first two seasons end in big triumphant victories, this one ends in a much more sad and somber moment, where so much has been lost and no one's really sure where they're going to go. But it leaves the series open to enter totally new territory in the future. So I stand by this season. It does have its problems, but it transitions the show into a more serious place pretty well. I think RWBY as a show, for the most part, has just gotten better and better since it started. The creators seem to have listened to the complaints people had with the first season and have done a good job of improving. The writing's gotten better, the characters have gotten more complex, and I'd love to see where the series is going to go from here. If you liked the first season, you're definitely going to like the second two. This is ShadowACS, and I'll see you next time.